Ronald Anthony Westerhuis. He's a famous artist, and very soon he will reveal what type of objects he is making and producing. And they're really stunning. They're big pieces. And before we start, you know, looking at his work, and he can explain to us about that. Where are you from, Ronald?
I'm from the Netherlands.
Yeah.
And I live in a small town called Zwolle. It's in the east part of the Netherlands.
Yeah.
And I'm a little bit in between the Netherlands and Shanghai. So I have a studio in Holland,
yeah,
where it's nice to create, you know, in a homely atmosphere. And I go for the madness. I go to Shanghai.
Wow, that's what I heard, right? There's a lot to do right now. Can you tell me, like, how did you get into Shanghai?
Well, actually, yeah,
from a small town in Zwolle, and then you have, you know.
Well, I've been traveling all my life.
Yeah.
In 2003, I designed the Olympic flame for China.
Wow,
so amazing. I made a design of 7 meters high,
yeah,
which was presented in Athens in the Holland Heineken House and was supported by the Dutch Olympic Committee.
Yeah.
So some Chinese saw the Olympic flame and they said, well, we need to get this guy to China. So I've done an exhibition in 2005 with the Olympic flame on Art Shanghai.
Yeah.
And that's where I met some Dutch business people and, you know, kept going, and
yeah,
now work together with Gijsbert de Bruin, a big entrepreneur, Dutch entrepreneur in Shanghai.
Yeah.
So we started up a studio 3 years ago, and we work in China because those people, you know, they're not afraid of big sculptures.
That's good, and they have the budgets, right?
I can imagine. Yeah, they have the budget, but mainly it's, well, I make large stainless steel sculptures,
yeah,
you know, landmarks, and like I said, in China, everything can be big.
Yeah.
So that's for me the ultimate way of working there.
I can imagine. So it's stainless steel, and how did you get fascinated by the material of stainless steel? Because as people know, it's not an easy material. It is beautiful when it's finished, but it's not like you have like a piece of, you know, you can mold it in any way you want in a second, right? So can you
True.
Tell me about that?
Well, before I started being an artist, first I traveled for 7 years around the world. And then I started working in the offshore fields, so on the oil rigs.
Yeah.
So we had to put in these massive pipes of stainless steel.
Yeah.
And I was totally fascinated by the material.
Yeah.
You know, it's very hard, it's indestructible, it's cold. But if you like you say, if you polish it, it becomes very sensitive.
Yeah.
If you see people looking at my sculptures, they always try to feel, you know, the perfect finishing. So I try to, you know, play with sanded stainless steel and high polish to get it a beautiful finish.
Wow.
So that's where the fascination comes from.
Yeah.
Plus, it's indestructible. So every piece we make, you know, it's going to last forever.
Ah, that's amazing. So, and then you do the very big objects, but I also saw you are specialized in very innovative type of things with furniture, cocoons, lighting. Can you tell people about that?
We started a company about 3 years ago called Raw Design.
Yeah.
This was because, you know, I'm not a designer, so I sculpt a chair.
Yeah.
And we started out with these big, huge chairs, we call it thrones, four meters long, meter wide, 800 kilos for one chair. And then I thought, well, maybe I can do something more with it, you know, make some little chairs, make lighting, and, you know, it's a different way of designing. I sculpt the pieces, but, you know, now it's in production and people love it, so.
Yeah, I think it's amazing when I saw that, because it's also something you can put in a park or somewhere, and it is a sculpture in itself, but it has a function too. So in a way, you could call it functional design, or maybe artistic functional design.
Yeah,
it's
a whole new
way of looking at furniture and materials combined.
True.
So my question also right now is, what do you want? Like, I read a lot about you, and I heard that your goal is always to find the amazing synergy, you know, combined with shape and form.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have any idea what you like to have the effect on the people with your design? What would you like to express with your design?
Well, see, first of all, I'm not a teacher, you know, with my work. What I want to do is create a perfect lining within that setting.
Yeah.
So, for instance, we've done a large piece for Shell, the oil company,
which
you like to represent the oil company in the sculpture, which is abstract, of course. So you have to tell people this is how I see it. But foremost, I like to, you know, I always say my sculptures are like positive energy sculptures. You know, people don't have to see, well, it's like this or it's like this. It's the feeling with the work. So I like to do a lot, you know, assignments are good for that. So you have one spot where you place your work and then, you know, the space and the sculpture become one.
Yeah.
That's my ultimate goal.
Yeah, and I think you're very good at that, because when you see, you know, the sculptures you make, they're kind of blending in the environment. Mm-hmm. It can be like a city environment or a company environment. It can be inside or outside. And it's just a stunning piece to look at. And I think it's very interesting what you say. You don't want to teach people. I think people are learning from the sculpture itself. They get their admiration, and it's for everybody.
Well, one of the nicest compliments I had, there was a lady looking at a large sculpture of about 6 meters, and she started crying. And I was like, what is this, you know, what's going on? So I went to the lady, I said, are you all right? She said, oh, this is the most beautiful thing I ever saw in my life, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's where you do it for.
Yeah.
That's where you do it for.
That is amazing. So, as you know, with Eisen Magazine, we feature a lot of, we ask people about their masterpieces. And any artist has their masterpiece, or maybe they have a dream for a masterpiece to make. So do you think you created your masterpiece already, or do you have dreams for the future to create masterpieces?
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, I don't... We produce a lot, and if I say we, I'm the sculptor, but I have eight people working with me. We produce a lot because I believe in you got to see it. I can make a drawing, or you got to see it. Did I make a masterpiece yet? I mean, that's not for me to say.
I think you did. many.
But as far as do I want to create a masterpiece? Well, my ultimate goal is to build Eiffel Tower size sculpture.
Wow.
That's what I want.
Yeah.
And currently we're working on a sculpture in Norway,
which
is going to be 300 meters high, so it's 900 feet. So that's what I want to create.
Yeah.
Because I believe in that, you know, I believe in the landmark, in the sense of, you know, positive energy, also identity to the people, also economical boost, because people go there and see it. If you know, in Paris, 5% of all the money coming in from tourists is coming from the Eiffel Tower.
Wow.
So that's the goal I have with my work.
And then I think that's a beautiful goal. So about the big object you're making in Norway, so you say it can be an economic boost. Can you tell us for who you have to make this sculpture, and how it's, what is the symbol, and how it will look a little bit?
Well, I was asked a few years ago, there was a question from the Norwegian government to say, okay, we have a lot of urbanization in the region, so young kids move to the big city.
Yeah.
So they did an international call asking basically anybody, what could we do to stop this? So there were a lot of architects, sociologists, everybody entered. And I was the only artist to say, well, you know, let's see what we can do.
Yeah.
So I came up with an idea to build in the middle of a fjord a huge object.
Yeah.
Well, it's three big pillars where you can go in.
Yeah.
And within the three pillars, from 150 meters high, it holds this huge ball, 30 meters in diameter, high polished, which you can go in. And we call it Global Peace Energy. Why? We want to make a conference center for the global leaders to think about the green future of the world, which Norway is a good example. You know, they make the money with oil, but they use clean energy. And it was embraced by the Norwegian government. The opening was done by Minister Kleppa, who was the Minister of Regional Affairs.
Yeah.
We started an education program for little children.
Yeah.
What's your identity? Where are you from? Does a sculpture fit in this environment? And, you know, we take it from there. This is like a process of years before it it becomes real. But, you know, that's something I do.
Yeah.
So I roll the ball. I just... You know, I put out the ideas, I come up with a scale model, and I have big companies helping me with the construction and everything.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I move on to the next thing.
Yeah. And that's amazing. That's the innovation thing behind the whole city branding and regional branding. That
true.
City branding,
true.
A lot of companies have to do that. They do it with events. But if you can do it with something that is permanently there, that is, of course, really amazing.
Yeah.
So one of my last questions, do you have a favorite artist yourself? And if you have any, or like an innovative creator, would you like to cooperate in the future with anybody from the other fields? Any of the other artistic disciplines?
Oh, I mean...
Not an easy question, so take your time.
Oh, no. I mean, I'm always intrigued by other kinds of art. I'm now looking a lot at video art, which I don't really understand the video art yet, but I like to incorporate it with my sculptures. Favorite artist, I love Anish Kapoor.
Yeah.
A very good sculptor, Richard Zena. I mean, I'm a sculptor guy, so that's basically what I go for.
Yeah, wow, that's great. So if anybody wants to see your sculptures or read about your sculptures, where do they go? Do you have a website?
Well, first you go to ronaldawesterhaus.com.
Yeah, okay.
You know, and have a look. And we're showing now on Art Basel in Miami. We have a great show in Shanghai. And we're basically traveling around the globe.
That's very nice. It was really good.
And of course, we are in Artiehoven in the Netherlands.
That's good. That's a beautiful sculpture park.
Yeah, that's a beautiful. That's they represent me in the Netherlands. So, if you go to Europe, you go to Asia, you come to America, there's always something to see.
Okay, great. It was very good to talk to you. Thank you very much, Ronald.
Thank you, Vivian. Thank you.